As you wake, the tadpole squirms in your skull. Other than the infection, you're more or less intact. A miracle, given everything you've been through. But it'll all be for nothing if you don't find help soon. The tadpole is a death sentence, and the clock is ticking. You need a cure.
These boots have seen everything.
You're alive. I'm alive. How is this possible? True. Seems like we're the lucky ones, judging by all the corpses strewn about. I remember the ship. I remember falling. Then nothing. No, I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. We need each other. And we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
Inside. Let's have a look. always room for more. Water. There must be a settlement nearby. More of those wretched things. Stay back. One strike could be lethal.
road ahead. Mind my step. Maybe I need more pockets.
Something the matter? There's no story. None that you're entitled to hear, anyway. Just forget you ever saw it. We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to exactly? I must admit, you've been a surprise, and not an unpleasant one. Kindred spirits are few and far between for me. Besides, you saved my life aboard the Nautiloid. How can I do anything but sing your praises? Must I? Thinking about it won't help. We know what to do, so find a way to rid ourselves of these things. We've no solid leads right now, though. We'd best get hunting. If you discover anything that might help us, I'm all ears. Must we? No harm in a little mystery, don't you think? Easy is often less interesting. Besides, we've plenty of reason to rely on each other already. You can't confide in just anyone about a monster in your head. Sweet of you, but don't worry. I'm sure you'll get to know me just fine by traveling together. No need for interrogations just yet. Thank you. I'm sure we'll get along perfectly well.
Here we go. What's in here? Thank you. what's up for discussion.
You strike me as the reliable sort. But are you sure this is a good idea? Outside threats, perhaps? Each hour that passes, the thing inside us grows. We need to find a healer. Let's wake up at first light. Maybe we'll get lucky. We're overdue some good fortune. Rest well. We'll need our strength.
What's next, I wonder?
Is familiar, but not comforting. It is a struggle to sink into your trance, weaving together memory, ambition, and purpose. The vision in your mind is simple. A stone altar to Lolth, the knife upon it bloody with sacrifice. Fire spills across your thoughts. Dragon's breath. The tadpole slithers, twisting deeper into your skull. Your head is about to burst. The memory consumes your mind, corrupting the trance. The flames cool. Dispelled as the image you know emerges again. Blood and darkness. As the trance stabilizes, your breath deepens. Be it cure or cage, something must be done about the tadpole. Every night that passes is another night the monster inside you grows.
Never a dull moment.
Something the matter?
Never wanted the easy path. Good here, I hope.
Wits and blades, always sharp.
At least things have stayed interesting.
Let's get on with it.
Let's get going. Best be on my way. No traps, please.
I'll take that. I need a quick word.
Harry, I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? I was hoping for a kind soul. Well, not to worry. I saw you on the ship, strutting about whilst I was trapped in that pod. What did you and those tentacled freaks do to me? You'll talk. I can... Ah!
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light. The fear.
What was that? What's going on? The worm. Of course. That explains things. Somewhat. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. A kindred spirit. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. A pleasure. So, do you know anything about these worms? Turn us into... Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. You know, I was ready to go this alone, but maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. like a useful person to know. All right. I accept. Lead on.
A mind flayer. And it's hurt.
That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if...
You approach the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel... compassion. Compassion. Yes, you feel hate. And you deserve to be punished for it. You should be whipped, made to bow before this creature in shame. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. Your minds fuse, lusting for something that is gone. But then its grip claws back with a vengeance, a vice locking your mind into obedience. It needs sustenance to survive, and with your very body, you can provide. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Monster. Death is too good for it.
Something good here, I hope.
Dead goblins over there. Worth checking for supplies, maybe.
Unstable somehow.
Approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous,
hand? Anyone? Whatever you're doing is working wonders. Now a quick little pull should do the trick. Oh. Hello. I'm Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. I'm usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Nausloid as well. Then I can only assume you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region.
The insertee we speak of, this parasite, are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided.
You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you?
A doctor? Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle?
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them. As we've established, few enough can. It's not exactly a common affliction. We're most certainly going to need a healer, and soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer together? Most excellent! A parasite shared is a parasite halved, or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you for pulling me out of that stone. It was an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
Not if it'll get me killed.
You're both twice as tall as me, but have half the bloody backbone!
But we don't know what that thing even is. And what about the crypt?
I'm telling you, it's a ship. And the crypt can wait. Mari and Barton have been trying to break in for days. Now we... Stop! Got ourselves competition already. That's our ship. Well, in that case, come on, you lot. No point in getting killed. Second worm gets the cheese and all.
Second mouse gets the cheese, no?
Nobody's getting any damn cheese! Now move it!
You're more cunning than you look. I thought we had a fight on our hands.
Time and the elements have left the plaque unreadable.
Something over there.
Yeah, it's packed too tight. We'll need a shovel. Shot.
No time to dally.
I've got a lot on my mind and, well, in it.
There's something underneath here.
One day I'll catch a break.
Of course it's dangerous. One of them carved up Zora.
What's inside? Wouldn't take much to send that stone crashing downwards.
Hmm.